Now, before I start talking about the paintings that I did in Provence and specifically for this video in Aix-en-Provence, I'd like to give a little background. Back in 2002, Sister Wendy Beckett, the noted art historian, had written a gallery, the Walter Wickizer Gallery in New York, about my work. She had seen an ad that the gallery had put in Art News, and she said, I'd be interested in seeing more of William Kelley's work. It seems to have a lyric strength that is very moving. Now that was in April of 2002, and that began essentially a 16-year relationship with Sister Wendy, including many emails, and not so much emails, many letters back and forth, and a visit to my studio in Florence at one point. But after a couple of years, she reviewed some work I had done from Tuscany, and she made a statement calling me the spiritual son to Cezanne. And I'd like to read from this little quote here. This was an excerpt. She was talking about a painting that I had done, and which was a landscape. And this is her quote about landscape. The painter sees what is before him, takes it into himself, understands and loves it, then recreates it for us. The double reality of what he sees and what he feels. Cezanne, to whom William Kelley is spiritual son, called his petite sensation, his reaction, the response that he and he alone could make. Now, this was taken from a critique of one of my paintings in 2005. And based on these comparisons with Cezanne, I decided at some point I'd leave Florence for a month, and Susan and I would go to Provence, because in addition to Aix-en-Provence, Provence basically goes from the Rhone River in the west of France all the way to the Italian, in the southeast part of France to the Italian border. And we found that it's only about a four-hour drive from Florence to Nice. But in addition to Aix-en-Provence, there's a major, major history with some of the most important artists in the history of art in the Provence area. For example, we had Cezanne, who lived in Aix-en-Provence, and these photos of me painting is at Mont Sainte-Victoire, which Cezanne, right outside of Aix-en-Provence, where Cezanne painted several hundred paintings, I believe, and he spent a good part of his life in Aix-en-Provence. Following that, you had Vincent van Gogh lived in Arles, and at one point Paul Gauguin visited him in Arles, and we're going to talk about that in a little more detail in a subsequent video. However, they lived together in the Yellow House in Arles and created some great paintings in a short period of time. Also, Picasso. The interesting thing, Picasso actually bought a chateau, which was behind this mountain on the photo on the right. It was called it's in the village of Vauvenargues, if I'm spelling that right, Vauvenargues. He bought a chateau there in 1958, and in fact he's buried there. And he and Matisse, who actually lived in Nice and there has a museum and a home now, well, he had a home and now it's a museum in Nice, Matisse and Picasso both said Cezanne was the father of us all. And then Sister Wendy called me the spiritual son to Cezanne. So I guess makes me spiritual brothers with Matisse and Picasso. But at any rate, there's a major history in the Provence area for art, and in a very, you know, they're all like, Arles is maybe 30 miles from Aix-en-Provence, and Saint-Remy in Provence is near Arles, and it's just incredible how these great artists all came to this one particular era. So I'd like to go on to the next screen, which is two of the paintings I did from my sketches here. I was able to walk out. We drove out, Susan and I drove from X, we parked, and I walked up to a spot on the mountain where I could paint. I didn't have my easel, but I had a sketchbook and I had some oils. I wanted to lay down the color. So that's exactly what I'm doing in these photos. And in fact, when we get to the next screen, you'll see two of the paintings that I did which are very similar to this photo here on the top right. All right, so now these are the first two paintings that I did when I got back to my studio in Florence following our month-long visit to Provence. And these are the ones I'm sketching in the previous scene, that view. And before I get into the talk about the mountains and so forth, I really noticed one major thing, the soil. The Tuscan soil is a little more sienna-ish, flesh-colored, whereas this red tone that we see in Provence is actually real. It's a little stronger, a little darker, and it's a pretty accurate color of the soil as it is in Provence. So now these are two 36 by 48 inch paintings, but the vertical is always something to me. A vertical always seems like it's bigger than a horizontal. But if we talk about the top painting first, the mountains are a little more generalized in this, whereas both of these paintings, you can see the soil and the colors of the trees and the plants are fairly similar. Just it's a little different section of the mountain that I'm painting. But in the first painting, the vertical, the mountains are a little more blended, sort of what I kind of did most of the time when I had painted mountains from Tuscany. And I was concentrating also on the shape and the form, but again, the balance and the composition. And I really like the flow of the mountains with the trees and then the reds. But again, there is a difference between the paintings of the mountains in the one on the top and the one on the bottom. And the one on the bottom, I began to get more into, I think I was thinking of how Cézanne might have done it, because Cézanne was known for really concentrating on forms. In fact, he's always been referred to as the link from 19th century Impressionism to Cubism. And that's what a lot of we mentioned before, Picasso and Matisse really felt he was the father of all of us. So I think the bottom painting is a little more in the style that maybe Cézanne would have done, because it was quite different for me, and I was concentrating on these forms in more of a I wouldn't say a cubist attempt, but they're very structured. And I think one of the other quotes from Sister Wendy, she talked about these and said it has its perfect harmony of form and color, which I thought was nice. But anyway, these are different, as you can tell, the colors are different from my previous Tuscan paintings, but I really feel that I captured the essence of the mountain and the land surrounding the mountain. And we can go on now to the next one. Here's another view of the mountain, Mount Sainte-Victoire, from a little bit of different angle than the other two. We're looking from the ground. This is the other two were from sketches I did while I was actually standing very close to the mountain. This is a little further away, and I'm in a field where we see the olive trees in the foreground, then some trees, and then some of that beautiful red-colored clay and dirt that was on the way to the mountain. And then, again, a majority of the painting, more than half of the painting, is on the mountain itself, and the color is a little more subdued. But once again, you can see the effects of being in Provence and looking at the paintings that Cézanne had painted. We actually did go to his studio. It was still there that he actually worked in and did many of these paintings, finished them actually, because he did a lot of the work, like I was doing, he did a lot of the work outside. But again, this one a little more subdued, more concentrated on the mountains, but the form, the forms are there, and it was an interesting experience for me to do these paintings, because I could understand then what people were talking about when they talked about his of Cézanne connecting Impressionism to Cubism. But again, or as Sister Wendy said, it was just his harmony with form and color. So this one it's a little bit small. This is 24 by 32, and I have this in my collection. Now we have the final painting in my series from Mount Sainte-Victoire in Aix-en-Provence, my homage to Cézanne. This is a combination of the other three paintings, very large painting. It's sort of my magnum opus. It's 60 by 72 inches. And I really had a lot of fun doing this painting. I've got, as I said, it's sort of everything that I learned from physically being on the mountain and looking at things and doing sketches and getting the real color feeling, and then the shapes of the mountain itself and the landscape of the trees. And then most of the stuff is very realistic. It was I kind of put the mountains in a little more. I have some great, I think, shapes and forms in the mountains, but they're a little subdued, whereas the trees in the middle of the painting are fairly realistic. And again, this red clay is very realistic, but I do have a little leeway with the trees in the pine trees and a little brush olive trees, and I kind of brightened them up a little bit because I thought it really did a nice balance with the subtle colors of the mountain and the shapes of the mountain, and then the pure green of the hill, not so much the hills, but the trees in the background, and then that realistic red. And I really like how this composition works. Again, it's very, very large, 60 by 72. As I mentioned before, many times I sent photos of my work to Sister Wendy and Wendy Beckett, and she just she really appreciates the work, and I think she describes it better than I can. And if you see this little quote, "Your work so rich, glowing, cheery, subtle, its colors and patterns so measured in their rhythm, impact of joy so deep, wonderful stuff. How Cezanne would love you." She's on that that Cezanne comparison, which I think I'm very honored for that, because that's quite an honor to be mentioned in the same breath. Thank you. So again, this would wrap up one of my more creative groups of paintings from this wonderful and inspirational mountain in Aix-en-Provence. Thank you.